Every year, there are great hopes for a warm and joyous holiday season. But for a lot of people, this time of year is marred by melancholy, worry, or depression. Professional assistance is undoubtedly most beneficial for those suffering from serious anxiety disorders or major depression. But what about people who, at this time of year, simply feel hopeless, overwhelmed, or lost? Being thankful is a fundamental part of Thanksgiving that has been shown to have positive effects on people's moods, according to research and common sense. The Latin term gratia, which can indicate grace, graciousness, or thanks depending on the situation, is where the word gratitude originates. Gratitude incorporates all of these meanings in certain ways. Having gratitude means appreciating what you receive, both material and immaterial. People recognize the goodness in their lives when they are grateful. People typically realize that the source of that goodness is at least partially external to them during this process. Thus, being gratitude fosters a connection to something greater than oneself, whether it be to other people, the natural world, or a higher force. Research on positive psychology has shown a substantial and continuous relationship between thankfulness and happiness. Those who are grateful are better able to handle hardship, enjoy good times, feel happier, and forge lasting relationships. People have different ways of feeling and expressing gratitude. They can use it in the present, not taking good fortune for granted when it occurs, the future, keeping an optimistic and hopeful attitude, and the past, retrieving happy memories and being grateful for aspects of childhood or past blessings. No matter how innate or developed a person's appreciation may be, it is a trait that people can effectively develop further. Studies on thankfulness. The majority of the research on gratitude has been conducted by two psychologists, Dr. Michael E. McCullough of the University of Miami and Dr. Robert A. Emmons of the University of California, Davis. In one study, all participants were instructed to write a few sentences every week that focused on specific subjects. One group wrote on experiences throughout the week for which they were thankful. A third group wrote about events that had an impact on them, without emphasizing whether the events were good or bad. A second group wrote about everyday annoyances or things that had irritated them. Those who wrote about gratitude after 10 weeks expressed greater optimism and improved life satisfaction. Interestingly, compared to individuals who concentrated on sources of aggravation, they also exercised more and saw doctors less frequently. Dr. Martin E.P. Seligman, a psychologist at the University of Pennsylvania and another eminent researcher in this field, examined the effects of many positive psychology therapies on 411 participants, comparing each to a control assignment that involved writing about early experiences. Participants' satisfaction scores skyrocketed the moment their week's task was to write and deliver a letter of gratitude to someone who had never received enough recognition for their compassion. With benefits that persisted for a month, this intervention had a bigger impact than any other. Naturally, research like this one cannot establish causation. However, the majority of research on this subject indicates a link between happiness and thankfulness. Relationship improvements resulting from gratitude have been the subject of other research. In a study involving couples, for instance, it was discovered that people who took the time to express thanks to their partner felt better about them, as well as more at ease talking about relationship issues. When managers remember to say thank you to their staff, those staff members may feel more inspired to work more. University of Pennsylvania. Wharton School researchers split university fundraisers into two groups at random. One group did what they always did, calling alumni to ask for donations. The director of annual giving gave the second group, who was scheduled to work on a different day, a motivational speech and expressed her gratitude to the fundraisers for their work. The university staff members who received her note of appreciation over the next week called for donations 50% more frequently than those who did not. The mostly good findings in appreciation research are notably interrupted by a few noteworthy exceptions. According to one study, middle-aged, divorced women who maintained gratitude diaries did not feel any better about their circumstances than those who did not. According to another study, kids and teenagers who thanked someone for changing their life by letter may have made that person happier, but they did not experience an improvement in their own well-being. According to this research, developing thankfulness is a sign of emotional development. Techniques for developing thankfulness. By practicing gratitude, people can learn to be content with what they already have, rather than constantly aiming for more things in the hopes of improving their life or believing that they won't be happy until all of their monetary and bodily needs are met. Refocusing on what they have instead of what they lack is made possible by gratitude. Additionally, with repeated use and practice, this mental state becomes stronger, even if it initially seems artificial. Here are some strategies for consistently practicing thankfulness. Compose a gratitude letter. By sending a thank you note or email to someone you appreciate their influence on your life, you can both improve your relationship with them and make yourself happier. Send it, or if you can, deliver it and read it out in person. Sending at least one letter of thankfulness each month should become a habit. Write one to yourself once in a while. Mentally give thanks to someone. Not enough time to write? Simply thanking the person in your mind when you think of someone who has been kind to you could be helpful. Maintain a thankfulness diary. Develop the practice of jotting down your thoughts regarding the blessings you've received each day, or sharing them with a loved one. Count your blessings. Set aside some time each week to make a gratitude list or a reflection on your blessings, including what went well or what you have to be thankful for. Selecting a number that you will identify each week, say 3 to 5, can be helpful at times. Be detailed in your writing and consider the feelings you experience when something positive happened to you. Say a prayer. Religious people can practice thankfulness through prayer. Think. Focusing on the here and now without passing judgment is a key component of mindfulness meditation. It's possible to concentrate on things for which you are thankful, such as the warmth of the sun, a soothing sound, etc. Even if people frequently concentrate on a word or phrase like peace.